Hey everyone, welcome back to Food, Wine, and Whiskey in Your Own Backyard. I am Rob, and joined as always by Carter. Carter, how you doing?
I am great. How are you?
Doing good, man. Very excited about tonight's show.
Yeah, man. It's going to be fun. We got a couple of special guests.
You want to say who they are?
Got the infamous podcast cask in front of us. Will and Greeze.
How you guys doing? Thanks, man, for having us on.
No, thanks for coming on, man. We really appreciate that. And you guys, I mean, I've been listening to your podcast, but really got into really getting into you guys, I guess I would say. That kind of sounds awkward, doesn't it?
I feel like you're just not that into me.
When you guys got onto YouTube, man, I really enjoyed that you guys went from the just a podcast format to the YouTube as well and started seeing you guys. I was actually surprised because I'd already been watching the Bourbon Junkies. And then lo and behold, one episode, I saw you guys kind of come on their channel, and then I saw them back on your channel. But what made you guys kind of have that decision to go from just the podcast? I think it's kind of obvious, but I'll let you guys tell everybody about that.
You got it? You want me to?
I can. I mean, the video world is kind of Greeze's baby. And so I work in audio. I love audio. I love audio entertainment. And for years, Greeze was always like, man, we need to do video. And I was like, man, you spearhead that and we'll do it. And it just took about 6 years for the Greeze to get his gumption going. Yeah. So that's about what it takes. But
yeah, and now that we've started it, I have a full appreciation of Will editing the show every week for 5 years.
And the audio edit, I mean, I do our audio editing, and it's a little time-consuming, but it's not that difficult. I've played around with just trials on some video stuff and then editing. Man, that's a pain in the hiney.
Yeah, there's definitely some grace when you're not visualizing what's going on. That's all in your mind. You can take chunks out, and it's not as obvious. When Greeze goes on a rant that goes maybe 3 or 4 or 10 minutes too long, you can condense that, and it's not as noticeable as when all of a sudden Greeze is here and then jump cuts over here. You know,
right, and it also gets weird, too. It's like you think I just said like a coherent sentence, but the beginning of the sentence – I had my shirt on.
Yeah.
And at the end of the sentence, it's completely off.
Much harder to paste that together in video.
Right. Me. Yeah. What am I trying to say?
I never know what you're trying to say.
It's just harder. Yeah. That's what I was trying to say. Yeah.
A lot more work goes into it.
Yeah. No doubt.
Well, I think everybody who, follows whiskey tubers, knows that you guys are in that community big time now. I mean, when we start talking about, we said Bourbon Junkies, we talk about it's bourbon night, and we know Perry from This Is My Bourbon Podcast and Shelf Turds and all that group of people. But I think, Greeze, I think you've kind of grown that fame, if you will,
well,
with the belt or the trophy that you now have.
I mean, are you saying that all of those channels owe all of their subscribers to me? Is that what you're saying?
I would say if there's a pyramid, you're probably on top now. Would that be fair to say?
For sure.
But I mean, it's a slippery slope. He can fall down at any time.
Oh yeah. I mean, I'm one like Facebook timeout away from just getting fully booted.
Yeah.
At this point. But yeah, the competition was awesome. It was super fun. I was telling Will the other day, I was like, I had no idea that I was half decent at it.
Really?
You were more than that.
Well, I feel like I got really lucky on the pours. Like if he starts, like I was having these issues with like Wild Turkey and Heaven Hill deciphering between the two. And the funny part about the final is I actually had the Heaven Hill Ball and Bond 7 year right next to me, and I was going to pregame with it, and I chose a Wild Turkey product, just the regular Russell's 10 year single barrel. And if I would have chosen the other one, it would have been, I would have assumed that I would have gotten one exactly right, but who's to say?
Who's to say?
But no, I got real. I think I got, you know, it's a combination of, you know, just what your pours are, honestly. And Matt Porter will tell you that too. So in the competition that he did, you know, it's a lot of luck, but then you got to have knowledge for sure.
Sure.
You know, you got to be able to, you know, smell rye and wheat on your nose, and you got to be able to figure out proof, low to high on the nose, and then in the palate and all that other stuff. So yeah, I mean, there's some skill to it, but it's also, you know, I mean, if he starts pulling out, you know, Discovery Series, whatever, you know, I'm not gonna be able to pull that out, you know, or some obscure brand from, you know, MGP. Washington State.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it's harder that way, but yeah, I got lucky, and there was, you know, and Kyle at the end was a really good competitor, and it was really fun. And Will always says that it ended perfectly.
Oh yeah, of course.
Cause I gambled.
Yeah. As soon as I knew there was a gambling element, I'm like, yeah, he won.
Yeah. Yeah. But anyway, it was super fun. And we love those guys. We love the Bourbon Junkies. It's Bourbon Night, ADHD Whiskey. We're actually having all of them on for Whiskey Weekend, Batch 4 this next year, which is going to be a heck of a fun weekend. And then next year, Lord only knows where we're going. But
and you brought that up. I've been looking into that, but people who might listen might want to, you know, travel a little bit. Yeah, I know it's Whiskey Weekend, Batch 4. You guys, this Batch 4, meaning it's the fourth year you're doing it.
Right, yeah. So we did a pod cruise 5 years ago now that we did with a couple other podcasts that we're friends with that aren't whiskey-related. We were the only whiskey-related one, but others that we have good relationship with, we did a pod cruise, and we had about 100 people go on a cruise with us and had a blast. We had a ridiculous deal of how much it cost, and it had the all-you-can-drink package. And so it was perfect. And we had a great time. We got to know some really good people. That was one of our first, like, interacting with people that were listeners, but like, yeah, I'll go on a trip with you. So we had a great time. And then we got off the cruise and we're like, we need to do that again next year. So we started looking at itineraries, trying to see what we could come up with. And there just none of them worked. None of them had either the same perks, or the ships weren't very nice, or just nothing was working out. And Greeze goes, let's do a pod cruise on the land. And I said, what? And he goes, yeah, like a pod cruise on the land where we just go to Kentucky and drink a lot with people. And I'm like, okay, if you can figure that out, sure, I'm in. And so then, like, a few months later, he's like, hey, I need a few minutes of your time in this afternoon. I'm like, cool. Yeah, what do you got? And he's like, okay, so we're announcing this on Monday. We're on our next episode. Here's where people sign up. Here's where we're going. I'm like, wait, what are you talking about? He's like, the pod cruise on land. We're doing it. And
we're calling it Whiskey Weekend.
Yeah. So we that was how Whiskey Weekend was born, was that Greeze, who is a cruiser, as they say, loves cruising.
I do.
Was trying to find a way just to drink with people and not have responsibilities for a weekend. And now we've done it 4 years. The first year we had 30 people join us at the Beaumont Inn in Harrodsburg, Kentucky, where Dixon Edmond is the proprietor. We had a blast, had a great time. The next year for batch two, we had 50 people join us there. And
which was the max we could have.
We was oversold.
Actually. Yeah, it was like oversold.
We were in trouble with Dixon a little bit, but we had the whole inn to ourselves both times. And then this last year we moved it up to Louisville, and we had just under 100 people join us at the Galt House in Louisville. So it's been growing every time. People have a blast. They make the best friends they'll ever meet. Yeah. We're already sold out for batch four, but keep an eye out if you're interested at whiskeytainment.com, because
you can always fill out the form there and get in line. You can
get in line, because people will, over the course of, it's next April, the very first weekend in April of 2022, and people, life circumstances happen over the course of a year.
Sure.
We try to give people enough time so they can, it's not going to be a burden, like, oh gosh, I got 3 weeks and I got to figure out how to pay to go have the best time of my life or something like that. So, give a lot of time, but people have to drop out. And so those spots do tend to open up a few of them over the course of a year. So that's what Whiskey Weekend is in a nutshell.
And so we say weekend, you arrive like on a Thursday and get ready at like 10 a.m. on Friday morning and it starts, or?
It starts Thursday evening.
Yeah.
We have a kickoff party. We have people bless our folks like you wouldn't believe. Like Dixon, he made the trip up to Louisville for one of the nights to do a tasting for the 100 people there, where we had
a custom blend
that he did for everyone that no one had ever had before then. And no, and he has one bottle. He saved one bottle.
He actually can't even make that blend again.
Right. Cause the stock is depleted.
Yeah.
And then, he poured dry state for everyone. And on that same night, Joshua Steely from Buffalo Trace was there.
Yeah.
And he brought for everyone to try,
18 year marriage
and CYPB.
Oh, wow.
So those were his first two pours. And then everyone tried them and he goes, oh, and then I've got a few more things. And he had
Eagle Rare BTAC,
Eagle Rare BTAC, George T. Stagg BTAC, and the Handy. Thomas H. Handy, all from 2020. So just in the pours that people got, they made up their ticket, but they walk away with some of the best friends they'll ever have. So
that's what it's all about.
Super cool, man.
Yeah. So it's legit adult summer camp.
So Whiskeytainment.
Whiskeytainment.com is the has all the sign up sheet and information, or get in line or get more information about.
There's just a form to fill out, and that just gets you in our, it makes a client profile.
Okay.
For you. And so I have all your information stored in there, and then I can
social, the mother's maiden name.
Right. All that stuff.
All the stuff you need for a weekend.
All the important stuff. Mm-hmm. Now, and then once if a slot becomes available and you're the next one, then I just shoot you an email and
send you a little money and you might be good to go.
Yeah, man.
Okay.
Yeah. It's humbling. It's crazy. Well, we opened this batch 4 up and we opened up 225 tickets and they sold out in less than 24 hours. So,
well, and
that's crazy.
Carter and I talked about going and by the time we got on there and found out that it was available now. We had realized
we were too late.
Got to be quick.
Yeah.
That's what she said.
Yeah. Well, you know, if you guys last minute want to come, just message me and we'll see if we can.
Okay. Mingle.
Appreciate that.
Yeah. All right. So what we did for you guys, we sent you a little blind, and Will, you need to forgive me because I haven't heard you say a lot about what kind of your favorite pours are. I think you're a turkey fan, if I remember hearing some episodes.
I'm an equal opportunity drinker.
Okay.
Then good.
So. Then you won't be disappointed. But I think we sent
them. I'm going to be upset, though.
You might be upset, Greg.
I'll be upset. Pretentious.
Right. Yeah. Right.
So this is a blind of some picks from our area here in the Houston area, from groups and stores that did these picks. There is a theme. I call it the Sesame Street theme because of the five. You know, one doesn't belong. You remember that little song from, you know, which one doesn't belong. So you're going to have one in there like that we'll see if you pick out. And overall, it's just to have a little fun, see what you guys think about some of the picks that came through our area. And, you know, Greeze, show off your skill again.
Yeah. I mean, he won Mad Madness. Come on. I mean, and he's going to pick the one hilarious. That doesn't belong.
And Will maybe you show him up.
Will actually has the better palette.
I was just getting ready to say, maybe Will shows you up a little bit here. I don't know.
I think I just know when things taste better. Greeze is actually able to pinpoint what they are.
Yeah. Will, 9 times out of 10, picks our single barrel. Like, I'll have... The one he picks is number 2, like 9 times out of 10.
So we just poured number 2. Is that the appropriate
number 2? That's exactly right. If you go in numerical order, even though they're not sequenced right, you're good.
And what are we supposed to tell you on these? Like if they're finished or if they're
just if you like it, what you think it might be, proof, just kind of a general what you think about it.
There's a lot of cherry on the nose on number 2 to me. Just right
the
off
the nose bat. Is really great.
Yeah.
Like it's bright. It's I'm getting a lot of bright fruit notes for sure.
I wonder why, Rob.
Like a cherry.
Oh man, a spearmint thing happening weird.
So Will, do you
that threw me off. Sorry.
Do you pride yourself on, you know, me? I'm going to tell you I'm not. We call Carter the Bloodhound. He can get in and dig in and kind of figure out what things are much better than I am. I think what you said is kind of how I describe myself. I can tell you if I like it, give you some, you know, simple notes and proof and things like that. But, you know, really picking it apart, I'm not great at that.
So I feel like I used to be better than you at naming what I was drinking blind.
I buy a lot more bottles than you. So, like, I think I have a more up-to-date like whiskey
collection. You have a lot of unopened bottles. You buy a lot more unopened bottles.
Yeah, because it's like
I buy a lot of bourbon, but I open them and finish them.
It's a museum.
Right. Yeah. Greeze. So what are you talking about? There's literally, I barely see anything. Tater.
I am getting Willet notes on this nose like no other.
This is two?
Yeah.
Yeah. See, he doesn't know what he's talking about. He's just throwing out words.
No, I'm not.
It's called spaghetti at the wall.
It smells like Willet.
Well, I did help pick two of these.
I think this tastes like Four Roses, personally.
It could, but I don't get what
It's not super, the proof doesn't seem super hot though.
I agree with that, but it's also on the nose. It can weird you out if it's.
Did you taste it yet?
No.
Are we supposed to?
Yeah, absolutely. Dig in.
Oh, it's got some heat. Really back. Oh, dude, this is. I didn't get any rye on the nose, but it is all back palate.
That's why I think it's a Four Roses. The B Nashville.
The better Nashville.
Mm-hmm. With, I don't know the yeast strain, but.
I mean, it's 110 proof-ish. Somewhere in there.
Could be. I don't know.
Now, this is the first thing I've had today.
Yeah, me too. See, so, to me, that's why I was thinking it didn't drink that hot.
Right. So typically when I'm doing like tastings and stuff, like we'll hit like a 90 proof or a 100 proof just to get acclimated. But
yeah,
we haven't done that today.
We had water and Chinese food.
Yeah.
That's perfect.
Yeah. I was ordering Chinese since we got to get ready. He was coming in from Houston. I live out in the suburbs. So
that's awesome.
Yeah. Okay. I got to ask you guys, obviously we talked a little bit about your YouTube and when you got into that, but the podcast been going 5 years now.
Yeah. We started in 2016 in May of 2016. So we just had our big 5 year milestone that we had. Man,
congrats. That's awesome. Yeah.
So were you guys like whiskey drinking buddies before? I mean, I'm sure you were, but how long before did you guys just kind of get to know each other and go, hey, let's do this? Or were you drinking booze together for a while and then just finally said, let's just put some audio to it?
So we work together in our day jobs as well, but we've known each other a long time. We met in 2006, I believe. And we would get together a lot with our wives and play canasta like old people would.
Yeah.
And we would get normally something, we'd get like a bottle of Benchmark and we would always destroy our wives in canasta the first game. And we would just be drinking Benchmark till the cows come home. And then the second game, half the time, Greeze would have to go sit on the couch and just go to bed because we had too much Benchmark. So,
but is there ever enough Benchmark?
Yeah, I mean, no, the answer is no. There's never enough Benchmark. But so we would, we'd get together, we'd drink, we'd play cards. And then when we weren't doing that, we would work, you know, hey, do you have anything interesting over the weekend? Do you try anything new? And most of the time it was like, man, I got a bottle of Maker's 46, you know, sprung for that. And, but we always liked it. And we were like, hey, let's just, let's get together and just put down some audio and just see what happens. And I made the biggest mistake of my life. And I said, okay, Greeze, when you get down, whatever comes in your head, I just want you to say it. Like, don't filter yourself. Just go for it. And then, I mean, we'll edit it later. And I've been paying the price for that.
Right.
For 5 years now.
All right, guys. I'm going for number two. I'm going Russell's 10-year 110 proof single barrel is my final answer.
Damn.
Okay. That Will?
Coming hard.
I think it's a Four Roses pick with the higher rye mash bill.
Cool. All right, we gotta saunter down these.
Yeah, you got like 30 minutes. I know.
Okay, so I did want to bring up. You said something about Maker's 46. Have you guys recorded that review yet? Just the standard Maker's 46.
No, we have not.
Nope. No, we need to.
Not yet. We could. Do we have one here? We could do a video on it tonight.
This is your house. You buy more bourbon than me.
Well, I've got these. Tell me, girls. I got these stupid baskets underneath here that I don't know what is in it.
All right, you want me to tell you what you're drinking as we go through them before we move to the next one?
Yeah, yeah. What was number two?
Yeah, number two was a pick that Carter did. It is Four Roses OBSO. It's tier three,
and I got the mash bill.
Yep, you did OB. Get the yep, and 115.6.
115. So I did not think it drank like 115. That was really good, Carter. Good job on that.
There was a dill note on the nose that I was like, I couldn't shake.
I just got a strong cherry.
I didn't get any of that.
So a quick thing and a little humble brag here. But I went to the big Four Roses charity thing in Nashville last weekend. And, not last weekend, but the weekend before.
In Clarksville.
When people found out that I was involved in that pick, they were like, that's the best one from that run. That's awesome. The nerds, like, giving you accolades. I'm like, wow, oh, man.
I thought it was good, but yeah, it was that good.
It was that good.
Dude, all those crazies follow those barrels.
Oh man, it's crazy!
Like it's nutso too. And like, if they go in there for a pick and they can only pick one barrel, but they really like another one, they wish they could have two. Then they're gonna circle back and ask Four Roses like, "Hey, has barrel number blah 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 been picked? Yeah. And if so, what market is it in?" And they'll freaking go and ISO the heck out of it. Try to grab it. It's pretty nutso.
In our market, Four Roses is like, I don't know why, Matt.
It's a Houston thing. People love Four Roses here, and nothing wrong with that because I love Four Roses. But there's a whole like cult following here in Houston on Four Roses stuff.
Yeah, I'm looking
at a cult right now.
Well, if the Four Roses pick comes through, it doesn't even hit the shelves most of the time.
It doesn't.
It's horrible because it used to you could go in and just buy one if you wanted to go get a pick. You know? Yeah. But they just
now it's like who's your top 150 people, right?
And that's how it is here. I mean, there's usually a line when somebody announces there's going to be a release of a Four Roses pick, but as I've traveled and went other places around the country, I'll walk in a little store and see them sitting on a shelf, and I've kind of noticed in national groups it doesn't seem to get the love that we give it here in Houston. I don't know. I guess we're just...
Yeah, I'm definitely a big fan of the single barrel picks. But I also like their small batch and their small batch select.
Same.
Underproof, it's great whiskey. So, all right, this is number five, right?
This is number five.
Man, you really went all over the place with these numbers.
Well, like I said, this is from one of Wade's blinds.
Okay.
All right, number five is Russell's 10-year barrel proof, 110 or 110 proof.
I got you down for all five for that same answer.
You'll get one, Greeze. I don't know. There's a little bit of earthiness on the back end of it to me that I would get from,
I'm not in the zone,
a Heaven Hill, or it doesn't go full like peanut, like Knob Creek, but it could be one of those like slightly off profile Knob Creeks.
Ooh.
And when I'm comparing it to the first one, while I didn't think the first one was that hot, this one, I mean, it could be five proof higher. It could be a Knob Creek.
I was thinking a slightly lower.
Okay.
So, I mean, like barely.
Well, I don't know what
Where's it hitting on the palate?
I don't know. I finished it too quickly. I don't pay attention to the. I just taste. I mean, it's a rye bourbon. This isn't a wheat bourbon. Wheated bourbon.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Are you? I'm not so sure.
Okay. I don't think it's a weeded bourbon. Don't you get that kind of earthiness on the back? It's not a Buffalo Trace product.
I'm getting it mid to front palate. That's my only issue right now.
Could it be something like a Rebel, if you're saying it's weeded? Like the that'd be 113 proof, the Rebel Masters Collection. And that sometimes it has could, some
but I want you back. To think I want you to think OWA on this pick.
I thought of that through. What are you doing?
This is seven.
That's the wrong one, dum-dum. We're on number five.
Yeah. Did he pour seven?
You are so stupid sometimes.
No. I pre-poured seven in here, but I went back and poured a little bit more five in this one.
I'm not so certain you know what you're doing.
I'm 99% sure. Okay. No, it's seven. I feel like it's got the best chance for a weeder.
Is that seven or five?
This is seven.
Well, why aren't you doing five? I don't think you know what.
This is not a weeder. Five is not a weeder.
This is Matt Madness. That's how you won with your trickery.
But five is.
I don't think five is a weeder.
Five is a bourbon. 100%.
I haven't tried seven yet, but I have a feeling one of these is a rye because one of these is not like the other.
All right. Just like in Mad Madness, you have to play the mind game.
What do you think five is?
And they've already said this is a theme. The first one, four roses. The thing
is, one isn't like the other.
Right. So we need to be thinking even proof levels. So it was 115 proof at first.
No, I don't.
So think now we need to dabble in maybe 114 proof right here. It's real close. Like right. The theme could be the proof.
Number five, what do you think it is?
Five?
Yes. But we have it moved from five.
Seven should not be in the equation yet.
No. He keeps talking about the one that no one has given him the permission to go to yet.
It does feel like an off-profile Knob Creek.
That's what I said. I think that's what it is. Final answer.
I'll go with you on that.
I think it's a Knob Creek store pick.
All right. This is another one of Carter's picks here. This is a OESO.
Oh.
Tier 6. 8 years, nine okay,
so the,
months.
So the theme is...
So there's a bunch of four roses coming out.
Well, we know you guys like four roses, so we want to,
One hidden gem in there.
This is 127.2 on the proof.
Are you kidding me?
Whoa, yeah. That drink's
number five?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow.
127.2.
Wow. That's dangerous.
ISO.
Yeah, that is dangerous.
Can you even say ISO anymore? Like, I feel like every time I say it in a big group, they're like, ban them.
Yeah, you're obnoxious.
No, but I'm pretty sure, apparently.
Hey, Greeze.
You know what?
Some groups, it's okay.
Yeah, because you know what? Some groups understand that Facebook isn't filled with a bunch of dumbasses.
Exactly.
Because let me go ahead and tell you what's going to happen. Hey, guys, y'all need to stop saying Ben and say Ren for recycle it now.
Oh, no.
Yeah, that's really going to throw Facebook off. They're not even going to know what hit them.
That sounds like something you would suggest. So let's pump the brakes on the name calling and the dumbass.
No, I would not. You know what I would say? If Facebook's going to burn it down to like, hey, Facebook, I want to buy this whiskey right here on your stupid Facebook group for $150. That's what I would say.
That's fair.
That's what I would say. I would embrace the mess.
I'll allow it.
I do have a question for you guys, though. So I know you guys are Four Roses fans. Is there a particular recipe you don't care for?
No. I've had picks I don't like, but I've never had it be like a blanket answer, like it's because it's this recipe.
Okay. Right.
I think I tend to like the bee mash bill better, but I don't.
Same.
I think I lean towards OBSOs.
Well, yeah.
Those are good.
Right. Yeah. and few and far between. But
yeah. They're coming back.
Yeah.
They're coming back right now. They're on.
Yeah. Well, last year was a big year for OBSO.
So, like I said, Greeze and Will, your ISO, Carter picked both of these, the OBSO and the OESO. So, I mean, somebody might have a bunch of bottles. You never know.
Well, slide
maybe I can get into that whiskey weekend after all.
Yeah, I'm gonna
boom.
Oh yeah.
Welcome aboard.
Well, we'll just have
the land cruise.
I mean, if you come shirtless holding four roses bottles, anybody gets in.
Yeah,
empty or full.
Right. Yeah.
No,
yeah.
I mean no, they have to have at least like a quarter of the bottle.
Okay. Right. There you go. Okay.
Yeah. And if you're a lady, you need to sign some sort of form, I think. That says that,
yeah, you should
releases you from all responsibility.
Right. Right. Exactly. Right. Yeah. Like that ain't on my conscience.
Right.
Yeah. You know what I mean? I'm not worried about my conscience 9 times out of 10, but
you want to sleep well that night.
Right.
Yeah. Mm.
Hey, Greeze, you should guess this one's a Russell's.
You really should.
I'd go 10 year.
110 proof.
Do you think this is Four Roses?
I don't know anymore.
It feels like Heaven Hill.
You could have thrown him some of that Wild Turkey Split that you got.
Yeah.
Oh, God. Wild Turkey Split label is some of the best turkey I've ever had.
It's amazing.
Yeah, we love it.
It's so good.
This one drinks hotter to me. Which one is it? It smells spicier, but we've had two high rye Four Roses.
I shot five. That'll dry your mouth out. I don't even have to clean out my belly button near my shower, dude. This thing will do it for me.
I have moved on to seven.
So I'm on seven too. But I was confused as you said that drink harder.
It does drink hotter to me. It doesn't. To me, it does.
Yeah,
and I actually only have one glass, and I know which order I poured them because I'm only doing one at a time. So.
Okay, question for you. You got a lot of the whiskey tubers coming in to participate and enjoy the Whiskey Weekend, Batch 4, and some of them came for Batch 3. Do you guys get out and about and go on the road a little bit and visit some other, you know, whiskey get-togethers, whiskey socials?
It's very hard for us because Will and I also have, like, full-time jobs. I know It's Bourbon Night just recently went full-time with it. It's
not out of the picture, though.
What's not out of the picture?
Going to other stuff. We haven't.
I was like, wait.
Quitting their job?
You,
what?
Are you changing careers? No. I just had this picture to quit. Of going to do other stuff.
Yeah. We've been invited to do a few things. It just has, a lot of things have to happen. We have families, we have full-time jobs, we have a lot of things.
We've had a lot of last-minute requests for things. Like, hey, do you want to come to this event? And we're like, you're in Philadelphia.
Yeah.
And it's Tuesday. Like,
right. How do we do that?
Yeah.
Houston has their sixth annual Houston Whiskey Social in November. And I know Chris, Chris Hart, mm-hmm. the name. Yep. I know he's friends with Bourbon Junkies.
Sure, and it's Christopher Hart.
Yeah, Christopher Hart. He does like to go by Greeze.
You're not on a first name shortened basis, so.
Right.
But, I know I'm assuming he's extended some invites to some of the guys, and I was wondering if you guys might be coming to town.
We'll have to check the spam filter. Folder.
Well,
that would have landed better if I didn't.
You got to execute that joke.
Combine the words.
So what day is it on?
November 6th. It's a Saturday.
Okay, well, we're in the neighborhood. We have some good buddies that live in Houston that are a part of our podcasters tribe.
We could stay with them.
And know that it's such a great scene there.
Yeah, so. it's some cool stuff. And I'll feed you well if you come to town.
Say that again?
I'll feed you well if you come to town.
Oh, we like that.
All I know is I want to eat well, and I want to drink some wine with you guys because that's like my favorite angle of your podcast.
Oh, yeah. I do love wine. I love red wine.
So, yeah, wine. As
of 2 days ago.
No, that's not true.
As of 2 days ago.
Dude, I mix red wine and whiskey. Let's go.
Yeah.
So wine is my first love. Whiskey is my second love. But my podcast, Food, Wine, and Whiskey, is because I like all three. And I thought they kind of all go together, man. I've never sat down and had a drink where I didn't have some food, you know. And usually I cook and have a pour of whiskey or a few pours of whiskey as I'm cooking and prepping food. And then, you know, when I sit down and have a meal, I like to have a, you know, bottle or two of wine, or a glass or two of wine.
I got a bottle or two. Huh?
Our friend Dixon Deadman has spoken the praises of the Houston whiskey scene often.
Oh yeah, he's done that a lot.
Most of the times when we get like a text of him with a podcaster when he's been on the road, it's from an event in Houston.
Really?
So it's always been a cool.
Yeah, cool it's place. A cool little. Yeah, it's a cool little hub there. Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
which is more podcast people instead of YouTube, I think, but
used to say, yeah.
Yeah. Well, if you guys make it, we'll say something to Christopher. We know Chris, he's been on the show, and we'll nudge him a little bit to make sure he hits your spam folder.
Yeah. maybe you can even get the BTAC tasting because it sold out in 30 seconds.
Yeah. All right. Which one of you guys?
I'd do it. I'd try the BTAC.
If you guys make it to town, it'll be nice weather. We'll fire up the pizza oven out back and pop a bunch of bottles of wine before you drink your whiskey the next night.
Pizza and wine? That's going to be bad for my acid reflux, so I'll have to pregame Prilosec. Hang on.
All right, we're going to number 10.
All right.
Did you guess what number 7 was?
No.
Oh, gosh.
I'm pulling a Greeze. I think it's O-E-S-K, Four Roses.
Okay. Really? Four Roses again? Why am I not good at Four Roses right now? I think this is not Four Roses.
All right, we'll take a guess.
I don't know. I think it's Old Fitz Ballin' Bond 9 year.
And Will's going with OESK.
I said OESK.
Oh, they're all single barrel picks?
He said that at the beginning. You have to pay attention.
Then I'm going to have to say Weller Full Pro. Cool.
You're wrong.
This is Four Roses.
Yes.
OESV, 10 years, 1 month, 128.4. So it is a...
These are high proof Four Roses picks.
That one drank chill to me. Way chiller than seven.
That's the one that I said was seven.
That was a Houston Bourbon Society pick.
Oh.
So this one is from Chris's group. Chris and a couple other guys picked it. Christopher. But this is
now.
They ran a series. What was that series? The Reservoir Dogs. They did picks for the Reservoir Dogs, all the characters there, and this is a Mr. Pink.
Ooh. That's like a flex when you can pick enough barrels to like fill an ensemble cast.
Yeah, isn't that right? Something?
Yeah. And they did it. All right.
You need to pour us something else.
Yeah, because that OESQ or OBSQ sucks. Sorry, I'm a Q hater.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
See, I don't have that much angst against a certain recipe.
And that's the reason I ask it. I happen to like... It's got that tobacco kind of note to it that I'm just not really crazy about. So
we talking about QAnon or what are we talking about?
No, you can't say that. They'll get deplatformed.
He said I'm a Q hater.
Oh, that's fair. Yeah, I think you can say
he's
that.
He's already said that.
Oh, God.
I didn't say that.
My bad.
So I don't want to get Navy SEALed.
Carter's telling you he doesn't like Q, but he's the one I said pour whatever you want, and this is what he poured.
Well, okay, so this is like, okay, I keep getting up to sit down, okay, this is like that. I haven't tried this tier six like total wine pick, and I've heard like it's pretty good. So
you thought you'd try it?
Okay, so like at the event at the event in Clarksville, that they picked a Q for the event, and it was the only Q that I've ever liked. And I was kicking myself because I didn't get the event bottle for some stupid reason, probably because it was a Q. But anyway, I knew you had this bottle and I've been wanting to try it. I'm like, maybe this Q will change my mind. But
did it?
No.
Okay, so I've moved on to number 10.
Yep.
And I'm getting tobacco and some leather on this.
Okay.
That because he is picking out that he doesn't like that note, I'm wondering if it's another Q pick. I don't know. 10.
This is not Four Roses.
I mean, to me, this does remind me of like a...
this actually like smells like Four Roses MGP to me.
Because of that leather age.
This actually smells like Four Roses to me.
That's fine.
Which means it's not going to be.
Fair.
Ooh, yeah. I feel your MGP, but I think it's Four Roses. This is the best one that I've had today.
Is it your favorite one?
I love this. Yeah, this one's so good.
Okay.
this one is going to be the one that's not Four Roses.
Is it because your palate's getting warmed up now?
That also could be it.
I don't necessarily know. We should have...
This one has much more oak influence than the others.
Okay.
So whether it's older, whether it's... Just mm-hmm. where it was. But to me, this one has a lot more oak influence than the previous.
Either that or it could have been higher in the Rick House.
Right. That's what I meant. Like there could be other mm-hmm. factors.
It's probably Four Roses.
Oh, dadgummit.
Wait, hang on. One is not the one.
I know.
Not
one
like the
one
other.
Is not like the others.
Is this Al Young?
No, I don't think so.
It's got the complexity.
He said they're all... Store picks.
You're right. But he also said one is not like the other.
But he said they're all store picks. Can I get a ruling from the judges?
You are correct.
They are all store
picks.
They're
all store picks. But that's why this one to me tastes like it's could be an MGP pick of something. Because it's got that oak that hits a lot. Which one are you drinking there, Carter?
Okay, so we got the this is from gosh, what is the name of that store? L5P something or other, but anyway, it's at OBSK, right around 120 proof, tier four.
Here you go.
8 years, 10 months.
Yeah.
I'm a huge Rob's K fan.
Rob's the guy that you want to party with.
Oh, yeah.
Carter's the guy that will show up if your tire is flat three states away.
Yes, he would.
And then party with you.
And
then
And I would also bring booze.
Right. Right. Like, he's going to have a cooler in the trunk.
Yeah, I've already got him.
It's like, man, you've had a rough night already.
Yeah, it's probably cold outside. I'll change the tire. Yeah.
I feel like Rob in his collection, too, has some really special things, but I just have, like, a lot more quantity.
Like, I don't know. Oh, that's us.
Well, you also have a lot of duplicates, and that's my problem. I don't buy a ton of duplicates. I buy one and drink through it.
I buy I do not buy one store pick.
Right.
Unless it's like, if it's,
I've started to change that about myself though. It was a personality flaw and I'm self-correcting. You know?
All right. So we used to only get two bottles of our own picks, like a bunch of dum-dums.
What do you think 10 is? I think it's an MGP pick is what I'm saying. Because I think that's the one that's different.
Which one did he?
10.
Did he just reveal it?
10.
Did he read it?
He didn't.
I have not revealed it yet.
What were they drinking? You don't pay attention. And that's what I love and hate about you.
I'm going to go, it's Four Roses.
What's the recipe? What are you thinking?
OESK.
Oh.
Will?
I think it's an MGP pick. Something, I don't know the label, but something that is a 12-year high rye bourbon.
Man, I almost sent him that.
I know.
This is a OESK.
You nailed it, Greeze.
Good job, Greeze.
Yeah.
Good job.
I mean, I had a 10% chance.
This is true.
Now that I'm playing the game.
Yeah, this is true.
No, honestly, it felt.
Those are your odds.
So OESK is like the most prominent. That's the most prominent offering.
Yeah,
they do.
I also, and I will say, felt
the most in the pocket for roses.
While I don't have a recipe I don't like, I've had the most OESKs I don't like, I think because it is more common.
Oh, that's interesting.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay. All right. Down to the final one. 11.
Fellas? So this is not Four Roses.
One is not like the others.
Maybe one's not a single barrel.
They said it was all single.
Barrels.
I know. I'm so confused.
No, they're all single barrels.
Yeah.
This one smells very different to me because I'm psychologically predisposed to be thinking that at this point. This one's much more perfumey on the nose to me.
I will say this one
tastes younger. It tastes younger to me.
This tastes younger. This one is definitely the different one.
I get a lot of corn on it. Did y'all distill this?
It's still got a lot of flavor on it.
Did you not like it, Will?
No, I think it tastes good. I think it's compared, especially when I've just done four Roses products.
You think this is finished?
No, it's not finished.
So you don't think this is Four Roses?
If it is, it I don't know. It just tastes like it has a lot more corn than I'm used to, which I mean, 51%.
Yeah,
but
this. But it's not it's not young. 6 years? 4 to 6?
It could be could still be in that 6 to 8 range if it's a different distillery.
There's great complexity to it.
If this is a Wild Turkey product, like if it's a Russell's pick, 110 proof, I could see getting some corn on it that I didn't get out of Four Roses. But I'm kind of in a
is your palate all messed up?
Yeah. Yeah, no, I am. I'm trying
to. He's flavor tripping.
Did I use conundrum at the right in the wet rave?
Yeah.
Right
no, way? I'm trying too hard to figure out what it is and what it isn't, and that's just confusing me.
Does a distillery come to mind that you think it might be based on what you're getting on the nose and on the palate?
It is a distinct yeast strain that's used in this one. I'm giving away.
Yeah, you are.
I feel like they need one.
Yeah.
They're way too excited about this, Greeze.
No, it's nothing.
No,
it's hot. I do think it's younger.
Yeah, it's a little bit less refined, I would say that way.
I do think it's just a standard bourbon.
But there's a different yeast strain.
Yeah, I don't know what this is.
It's
a different yeast.
I wouldn't say different, but I'd say distinct.
Okay.
You want us to just tell you what it is?
Yeah, I'm not going to guess. Yeah.
It's from a local liquor store, Specs. It's the Old Forester single barrel strength. It's at 128. I think those are, what, 8 years, seven, eight years, something like that.
Yep. Yeah. No, but now that you're saying that, I can Brown Foreman. And what you're saying, yeast strain. With get a little bit of that banana that comes through with that. I get that now. Yeah.
I personally like all of these picks.
It's good.
They're all pretty good. But I would be interested to do this blind because I've never really like stacked a bunch of four roses and then just gone straight to like a single barrel Old Forester barrel proof pick. Like I think it might get crushed.
Well, and that's the difference to me, especially with it coming at the end, is that we had four, even though they're different yeast strains, even though they're different mash bills, they all share in their profile. There's four roses taste like four roses.
Yeah.
If we did four Old Foresters and then threw in a curveball of four roses at the end, I feel like we'd have the same almost like, whoa, like you've been almost conditioned within this spectrum. And then all of a sudden you're just throwing a curveball in there that my mind could not wrap its head around.
Yeah.
What I was tasting.
Well, I mean, in 8 years on the lower floors of a Rick House, interior, you know, whatever placement, I mean, it's going to age slower. So we would get some younger notes on an eight potentially, but
you
it still
specifically
had,
where it was. Do you know? Is in
No, I don't. Internal? I don't. I'm just saying there's a fair shot of it being in a different place. That's why we picked it up on being a little low.
But don't they heat cycle the warehouses not to, you know?
Brown Foreman does, I believe.
No, do they?
Yeah, this is Warehouse K, floor five.
So mid.
Mid.
Yeah.
And I wonder where in the mid. In the mid? Doesn't matter.
I don't know. I've been trying. That is good. I've had two for Old Forester single barrels thus far. We haven't seen a ton of them in our area, and but both of them were. I got one that was had like a Mike Tyson sticker on it or something on it that was from Georgia.
Punch out,
phenomenal.
Really,
really good. Yeah. So I
it's but you haven't seen a lot of these out in your area.
No,
really?
No, okay. I snagged one from Georgia.
Right. I have one from Georgia and I have one someone else gave me. I'm not quite sure where it is, but we haven't,
they've hit here, but I have not many, maybe a couple. And we just didn't get it.
Yep.
I gotcha. Are you guys Old Forester fans?
Yes. I like Old Forester. Okay, I would say it is, I mean, it's not my favorite of the distilleries, but I, especially the single barrels,
I mean, they're 86 proof, 90, 100, bottled and bonds, rise, all
1920 are just so
consistent. Yeah, that 100 proof rye for like $22 is like,
you can't beat it. You really
unbelievable.
Can. Well, tell and everybody.
I like the other, the Whiskey Row series too.
I think that's
really good. So,
well, we know you guys got to get going. You're on a tight schedule, but we appreciate you guys coming on and just kind of letting us visit with you a little bit for our listeners who may not know you. If they want to go find you, I mean, obviously podcast at YouTube, but where else can they find you as far as the podcast and maybe if they want to get involved with supporting you guys and things?
Yeah, the podcast.com has pretty much our feed in it and a lot of our social links
if you want merch or something like that. But also we have patreon.com/thepodcast. We do something called Town Hall, which is Zoom meetings with us where we literally just drink whiskey with some of the best people you'll ever meet and stay up way too late doing that a lot of times on a school night. So that's a fun way to get involved and meet new people as well. So,
yeah. Awesome. Very cool. Well, thank you guys for coming on. We really appreciate
it.
Thanks
for having us, man. We enjoyed this. I'm telling you, I don't think we've ever been poured this kind of caliber of pours for a blind show.
That was an incredible lineup. Thank you.
We wouldn't have messed with your minds, too.
Yeah.
No, you did.
They didn't send us Tabasco Dickel. You know what I mean?
Right. You had that at the end of that.
Right.
If we get the opportunity to do it again, we'll try to change it up a little bit, maybe send you something a little bit, you know. Well, anyway, we'll change it up.
Awesome. Yeah, we'd love to hang out with you guys again, and hopefully someday in Houston. That'd be a lot of fun.
Yeah,
definitely hit us up.
Well, thanks, guys. Well, we appreciate it, man. Thank you so much, guys, for having us.
Yep, you guys have a great night.
Absolutely.
All right, thanks, guys.
All right, man. Very nice of those guys to join the episode with us.
Absolutely, man.
That was a lot of fun.
I think we made some new friends.
I think we may have made some new friends, and maybe we'll get invited to or if you look at that, I'm reaching over.
Yeah, I know. Thank you. I must have a dog hair on here.
You reach into the cellar, maybe we'll get a chance to go over to Whiskey Weekend.
I guess I got to work on toning up.
Yeah, no kidding. Yeah.
But anyway, no, that was super fun, man.
Yeah, very cool of them to come on. It was kind of just a shout out by me. You know, he had made a comment on the podcast, and if you guys don't know, he's got a Facebook page as well. And it's a fun group, man. They really do. It's a smaller group, so they really do a good job of just kind of keeping the banter lighthearted and a good time.
Yeah.
But he put out a comment, hey, anybody got a podcast or a show you want me to come on? I'll do it. And I went, nah, this guy's not going to do it. And I sent him a quick message, and he's like, yeah, let's do it, man. And I thought that's super cool
of
him. Yeah, him and Will. So there's a whole lot more conversation I'd like to have with those guys. And I know we were kind of crunched on time tonight, but hopefully we'll get an opportunity to visit with them again. That was a lot of fun.
Definitely.
Well, thanks everybody for joining us on this episode of Food, Wine, and Whiskey in Your Own Backyard. And until our next episode, enjoy your next pour.
Enjoying it now.